Fucking here we are, Saturday night. What is it? What's the date today? April 6th.
The 6th, man. Yeah.
The 6th. And this is Big Guns, Little Peckers. Big Guns, Little Peckers. I don't even know what episode this is, but whoever is listening, hopefully, yeah.
And don't forget to tell your friends what happens if they fuck around here. You understand?
I'm sorry, I made a bad mistake.
You're fucking right you made a bad mistake.
I really wish.
Because if you come back here, we catch either one of you, we're going to break your fucking heads and you won't walk out of here. You see that fucking saw? We're going to use it. You don't fuck around in this place.
Yeah.
Oh,
that'd be awesome. Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah. We're not gonna hear it.
No.
What if I turn on my shit? Can I listen to our shit through my phone?
Possibly.
Would it fucking echo through?
I don't know. We can try it. We can try it. We'll wait and see if somebody else is
gonna check it out.
Yep. There's this one gal that used to fucking always talk to me and Jake all the time. And I can't remember where the fuck she was from. I sent her a painting, dude.
No doubt.
Yeah.
Like, thanks for listening.
Yeah.
That's fucking pimp.
Well, because like...
Is that fucking Mike going to pick me up way over here?
Oh, yeah.
Because I don't feel like sitting on Jake's lap, and I don't think he wants to do that.
Yeah.
Either, no,
well, I don't think he wants to sit on mine either, man. It's going to be weird.
Yeah, I've used this before, and I've actually, when I sit there and wait for Maisie to get out of school, I'll just like hop on there just to see, and it fucking...
Fuck yeah, man.
Yeah. Because Jake usually just sits over there.
Right where I'm
at. Yeah, it's a pretty good fucking microphone. I think that thing was only like $20, dude.
No shit, where'd you get it?
That's fucking Amazon.
I was gonna say, Amazon.
I fucking love Amazon, dude.
Mm-hmm.
But they are definitely closing down a shitload of stores.
Yeah, dude. It's kind of sad. It's
that internet shit is like shut down. Like, no more Hastings? What the fuck, man?
Dude.
I used to fucking go trade in like 30 games just to get one game.
Yeah.
I,
movies and shit. That's how you should probably share this. $10 your tin bag, man.
Like,
yeah, dude.
Yeah, I was kind of bummed when I went to Gillette last time and didn't,
I missed the whole Red Movies thing.
Redbox.
Yeah, Redbox sucks dick. $2 a fucking day.
It's $2 though?
Fuck yeah. Some of it, if you get the Blu-ray, it's like $2 a fucking day.
Yeah.
Or you can get like $2.50 for 2 days.
Blu-ray is cool, but fuck that. I'll spend $1.
Yeah, I don't even mind.
Dude, I about yeah. Just typed in there, fucking, I like Blu-rays.
Just listening to the conversation.
They're cool. They are.
I like watching them. They're
pretty dope, but I don't want to spend the extra if I'm going to rent it. If I buy the movie, I'll buy a Blu-ray. For sure.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Well, shit, that one time, fucking, I didn't realize that Xbox, you could fucking play Blu-ray with it.
It doesn't?
Yeah.
It does.
It does.
Well,
Blu-rays the shit out of the HDMI cord in the back, dude. That thing will make that fucking thing poppin'.
Yeah, it's fucking pretty sweet. Pretty sweet. Oh, yeah. We got some current events. We ain't got nobody listening yet. Which is cool. I suppose.
If you're just tuning in...
Yeah, if you're just tuning in.
We'll catch you up real quick on all the shit we haven't talked about yet, but are about to.
And we're trying to convince OT Bone over here to get a Macho Man tattoo tomorrow instead of the other one.
It should happen.
Yeah.
It probably should happen.
Yeah.
It probably should.
Yeah.
There's a possibility, you could
put it on your leg.
The only tattoo I got on my leg is a macho man.
Fuck that, dude.
That's the best.
I could put it on my ankle, I guess.
On the top of your foot.
Yeah, there you go. That ain't gonna happen.
That would hurt.
My steel-toe boots would fuck that thing up, dude.
My wife has one on top of her foot. She said it fucking hurt.
Yeah.
Like a motherfucker.
My little sister has a fucking armpit tattoo and I don't want to leave her.
I've never seen that.
She's like wanting to get the other side down or something. I'm like, you're fucking nuts with that armpit tattoo.
That is nuts.
I got it just like barely into like the crease of the armpit and I fucking squealed like a cheerleader about to get raped.
Dude, fucking my sister got like her whole fucking side done. It was like the Nightmare Before Christmas shit or whatever.
Yeah.
And I was like, so how did that feel? I bet it felt amazing, huh? She goes, I'll never fucking do it again. She's like, it hurt bad.
Yeah. I just got some fucking wording done right here on my side. and it's starting to fade out and everything. And I'm just like, fuck it.
Yeah.
I don't want to go through that shit again. That was fucking rough. And they say going over another tattoo again is kind of rougher. I was like, I don't know.
I'm sure you're just playing through scar tissue.
Yeah, just fucking.
I mean, I kind of, I thought about, like, covering this shit up, but, like.
Why?
I don't know. I'd rather have, like I was telling you earlier, I'd rather have, like, the back piece that I'm probably going to get as a fucking sleeve. But, like, this shit's never going to go away. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's a tattoo, bud. They're kind of permanent. I don't know what they told you when you were getting them, but, yeah, they're kind of fucking permanent.
Yeah.
I mean, they're like, fucking weird, too.
Yeah.
Fucking that movie, The Dirt, dude. They fucking painted MGK all up and covered up all of his tattoos, and it shows what he'd look like with like out tattoos. It's kind of fucking weird.
Yeah.
Like he has like his whole fucking upper body done, and then when he does that movie, they paint over him.
Crazy. Like, weird. Fuck shit. That.
Oh, fuck. Make them all look just like the normal neck and shit.
Oh yeah. So, these current event things.
Oh, crap. I'm trying to avoid this.
Let's talk about that.
Okay, here we go. Number one.
Gay.
Okay, so I didn't read the whole entire article, obviously. It just popped up on a Facebook thing. There was a McDonald's billboard on the state line of New Mexico and Colorado.
Oh, this is the fucking one where he's crossed up?
Nope. It's a billboard on a highway, okay? And it says, there was a picture of a wrap. Like, you know, the fucking wraps you can get from there or whatever. Yeah. Well, the billboard said, usually when you roll something this good, it's illegal. And people were getting pissed about it.
Whoa.
It didn't say if they had to take it down or anything, but that's fucking bullshit. See, like,
billboard, you know your life's fucking shitty.
Well, yeah, but it's like,
you're driving into Colorado.
Yeah.
Get used to it.
You don't see, like, I mean, it's funny.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. It's fucking hilarious. Yeah. I mean, but seriously, I mean, how boring is your fucking life? You gotta get bent out of shape and fucking build.
Older people?
Yeah, they really don't have shit to do. Because once I get old, dude, I'm just gonna wake up super early to drive slow as fucking town. That's all I'm gonna do.
You know what? I remember when SpongeBob SquarePants was the thing.
Trying to convince me you're not a millennial. I know when SpongeBob wasn't even alive. Yeah. Shut up. You were born in 93. You grew up in the end of the era.
That's funny. Shit.
I'm not a millennial, man.
Yeah.
You think I am, but I'm not. I'm like, all right, bud. Fucking Geller, dude. He's awesome. He's the shit.
Oh, fuck. But yeah, what kind of piece of shit are you if you fucking have nothing else better to do than bitch about
a
billboard saying that.
Not important anymore. I'll quit.
There's comedy behind it.
They should probably smoke a joint.
Yeah. It's a good thing that you're...
Yeah, fucking chill the fuck out. Yeah.
You forget about that billboard and your bills.
Yeah, actually, it'd be like, that billboard's right. I'm going to get myself in there.
Well, you know it's got to be something that's like hella fucking uptight.
Never
you know what I mean?
Like a cop.
It's a New Mexico cops. Bro.
Yeah.
Some fucking Californian coming over here with his little fucking cancer billboards.
So I guess speaking about millennials, I found that a 27-year-old is suing his parents for being born because he doesn't believe that.
I fucking think I just lost some brain cells.
Was that on the Onion, Steve?
I don't think so. I don't know.
If it's on the Onion, you're getting thrown. No, it's a fucking lie.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, but I'm
that
just
sounds
like,
ridiculous.
What
but honestly, I can fucking believe. Yeah. I'm like, that's gotta be a lie. Yeah. I fucking believe.
Well, you know,
there's probably a certain section of this weird fucking country.
Yeah, or getting all pissed off. I was born a girl and I'm a boy, so.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. Yeah. Way to go, Dad, and your chromosomes. Fucking fag. Hopefully there's nobody, you know, homosexual in there and heard that shit. Yeah, we're getting sued.
Mm-hmm.
He said the F word, fuck. No, the other one.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh. Shit, dude. People in this world will do anything to save money. Quick buck.
Do you want one of those or what?
What?
PBRs, bro.
Oh, yeah. Fuck me.
Yeah. While you're right there, you want to hand me one? I'm going to be honest. That's part of the reason why I didn't want to get in there is because I was made a fuck over there. Thank you, bro.
You know, they're... They don't sponsor us, but it'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, PBR. PBR, dude, that'd be fucking pivot.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
That'd be like free beer, man.
I need to really try to enter that fucking contest.
So you ever get a fucking beer that's just like really sticky and shit from like out of a fridge, and then they try to lie to you and tell you it's fucking textured?
You did that too.
Yeah. I fucking opened up and I'm like, what's wrong with these cans? It's like it's textured, dude. I'm like, what the fuck is these?
That's what the lady told me that one day.
That lady told you that.
Yeah, she goes, that's awesome. I was like, oh, sweet. Some new cans. These are pretty sweet. She's like, yeah, and they're textured too. And I'm like,
what the fuck? Do you know what texture it is?
Yeah, I was like looking at it. I even fucking sat and felt it. I was like, yeah.
Nothing. You're like, yeah, all right.
It's not even raised up or anything.
Yeah, like, how is this even textured? There's a design on it, but that's about it.
Yeah.
Oh, those ones?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's...
It's textured, bud. Okay. He's off the acid there, yeah. Ron.
Oh, shit, you should have... There used to be this one guy there, man. Like, it would seriously piss you off. Like, I got pissed off one day, and I don't usually, you know, get pissed off about dumb shit like that. But this guy literally took about, fuck, a half hour just to get us all of our shit, dude.
What?
Yeah, he'd come and he'd give us one thing, and then he's like, so what was the, what else were you guys looking for? And then
he was fucking with you, man.
Oh, that guy was...
The joke's slow. Only funny if it lasts for a little bit, yeah. Not the whole fucking time.
Don't you see there's...
He's like, I have seen nobody all day.
Yeah. Yeah. He sees you, he asks you what you want, goes back there, hits the fucking acid, and he's like, what did he want?
I think he was on pills or something. Yeah.
Snorts an ox, goes back on relax. So what'd you want, man?
Yeah, where am I at again, bro? So, like, all right, don't call me fucking bro.
Yeah.
I had an old man say that to me the other day.
Don't call me bro?
Yeah, he's like, there you go, bro. And I'm like, what the fuck?
Whoa,
you're like 85 years old.
Jeez. Once you get past 55, you can't say bro no more,
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
Unless you're talking to your real brother.
I don't think I haven't told you about this incident. So, what was it, a couple weeks ago? It was Friday. I'm getting gas at the fucking Loaf and Jug and, come outside and like the tire on this fucking like Denali was like damn near flat, dude. So I was like, should I see anything? Probably should, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, anyway, I fucking that fail guy's like, so what are you doing? And I was like, well, I'm gonna try to flag this lady down, but she's on the phone. Well, then she fucking, I was like, hey, I just wanted to let you know that your tire's pretty low. Oh, sweet. Dude, I'm eating a fucking sandwich that I got from the Loaf and Jug. She's like, do you think you can help me do it? You know what? I'll even give you a McDonald's sandwich. And I'm like, or a sausage McMuffin or whatever. And I'm like, well, I'm good. I'm like eating right now. But yeah, I guess if you pull over there, you know, I can do it or whatever. She fucking pulls up there and she's like, yeah, I just bought these tires a while ago. Which was a fucking lie. She said they were like brand new, but you could tell they weren't. Dude, it was
racing
bad.
Slicks.
Yeah. Well, then she's like, yeah, my husband used to do this for me all the time, but fortunately he beat the shit out of me the other day. And then I was like, whoa. And then she like came up there, you know, and fucking she had a gnarly shiner on her fucking
eye. Oh, fuck.
Yeah, and I'm like,
Don't you normally abuse women say you hit the door? Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, I would.
She was looking for some help.
Yeah.
That's what she's doing.
She said she was fucking going to a divorce lawyer too or some fucking shit, but I'm just like,
damn. She probably socked herself in the fucking face and just is gonna be like, yup, he got me, man. Fucking dude,
I don't know. Just like, it's crazy because it's like, why the fuck are you telling me all this? I don't need to know this. Like, I'm just trying to help.
She was looking for stranger, help. Just like,
what do you mean, like, looking for help?
She wanted you to go over there with her and fuck him up.
Yep, pretty much. Fucking take her.
Like a hired contractor, basically.
Fucking This is a call for help of some sort, I bet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know, man. You just missed an opportunity. You could have beat up the husband and just, like, walked out with this little lady.
Yeah, like the Hollywood shit.
Yeah, just, like, walk out with Jessica. You guys are both now sister wives.
I would cool this because this is
happening. Jessica would whoop your fucking ass.
No,
bro.
That one day, it was funny. I think we were actually doing a podcast one night, and we were fucking talking about it, and she's like, you know what, honestly, just as long as I do, like, the laundry and the dishes, you know, I don't give
like
a shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty funny shit. All right, so, okay, here's another good one.
Hey, is there anything left in the...
Yeah, a 51-year-old lady almost dies because she was injecting herself with fruit juice into her veins. What the fuck?
What the fuck?
Well,
that's
yeah.
That vitamin.
Yeah. Yeah, you probably would fucking almost die.
Wow. Yeah. It's like the stupid kids at that college party a fucking way while back. They were having a blacklight party and shit, and they were breaking up glow sticks and injecting that in their skin so they glow underneath the fucking lights.
What?
Yeah,
the
fucking one of them died, the other one was in the ER for like fucking a month and a half.
Holy
Jesus.
Shit.
Fucking
yeah.
Idiots, dude.
That's crazy.
Turns out Hawaiian punch isn't fucking good to inject.
Yeah.
Apparently mainstream.
Yeah, I wonder what was it, Welch's?
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe try a different flavor.
Yeah, no. Try the fucking Capri Sun. Yeah. Get it fucking real.
Yeah.
You can just shove the needle right in the fucking pouch.
Yeah.
It's made
for. Oh, yeah. Got that juice.
Like
yeah.
It's like the morphine fucking shots or whatever.
Dude, those are fucking awesome. Those are legit. And you squeeze that fucker in there. Oh, man, my grandpa, his brother had, like, a box of, like, shit from World War or, like, some kind of war. I can't remember what war it was. Mm. But he had, like, those little fucking morphine patches that were, like, this
really?
Big with a little big old needle on it. He squeezed it in his leg and fucking put it on there. Me and my cousin Randy got fucking stupid one day and thought we should do it. Yeah, we didn't fucking move for, like, hours, bro. Right there on the floor with, like, a box and that. My grandparents came in and they looked at us, what the fuck are you doing? We're just laying there. Nothing, man. Yeah. We got our ass whipped.
That is great.
And it was so old and probably outdated, like it's not really out of us.
You were probably like borderline fucking OD. You're just like, oh.
Just laying there. Just dumb as fuck.
Dude, that's awesome. That's a good story.
My cousin Randy fucking told me to do it, though, and I was like fucking 9.
Yeah.
You were like, 9?
Yeah, dude. He was way older than me. He's like 10 years older than me.
You're
he's like, who's shooting
up,
dude?
Fucking 9.
I was like, shooting up. He's like, hey, it's for war, dude. It helps you with pain. I was like, alright. We both did it. Died. Not really that's died, cool. But we passed the fuck out, though.
Dude, I fucking watched this movie a couple weeks ago, I think it was. But like, so these guys are like in the fucking desert or some shit. I don't remember exactly where it was at. But they're in a fucking minefield, dude. And like his buddy actually fucking like blows up from one of the mines or whatever. But that guy was like stuck on that mine for fucking like days, dude. It was one of those like crazy movies where it's like, holy fuck, man. This would like really suck. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're out there in the fucking middle of nowhere. You don't got nobody. Yeah, and you know you're going to probably die.
Especially starvation, dehydration, yeah. When that shit kicks in, hallucination comes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know those miners down in fucking, like, I think it was Indiana. They were down underneath, and then they were drilling on top because they were going to blow up the fucking top of the mountain and shit. And they fucking were drilling down, and the drill bit came through the fucking top of this thing. And I mean, the drill bits are, like, the size of this fucking fridge right here. And they come straight down on top of them. And they fucking start to run out, and then the fucking whole thing keeps them in there. And they were stuck in there for, like, fucking, I think it was, like, 64 days.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, just living off of, like, what do you eat down there? Like, they have, like, little survival packs, but those things aren't fucking meant for shit.
Yeah, not meant for fucking 2 months. Holy shit. And they've made it?
Yeah, they made it out.
Wasn't that in Kentucky or West Virginia?
It's
in
Kentucky or Indiana. Somewhere over there.
I thought
it was
back east. Virginia.
Actually, because we had a big old meeting about it in our fucking mind.
Yeah.
It was crazy, dude. But, yeah, man. And then they, like, remember when you were kids and your mom would always be like, don't put a fucking bag over your head?
Yeah.
Our fucking survival kit is putting a bag over your fucking head and turning the CO2 oxygen.
Really?
That's fucking it, bro. It's like a big old clear bag. And you just put it on. And it doesn't even, like, really zip up or anything. It just siphons the air through. But it only has, like, 10 to 15 minutes of fucking air.
You might be almost toast.
Is that for, like, H2S or something?
Yeah, just in case. Because, like, when shit blows up there, the fucking methane. We got a whole methane film we're about to hit. And that's why all the yellow smoke and shit comes up when we blow shit up.
Cool.
So they were down there, and they were just, like, breathing through airbags together. At that point in time, you're going to look at, like, the fat guy and be like, you're going to die. Yeah. I will eat you.
Yeah.
Yeah, shit.
Fuck, I remember when I was living with my mom. Up there, and, like, they'd be fucking blasting at the marsh. It'll fucking...
Bad toss, bad timing. I distracted you.
Fucking... You could feel, like, the house fucking... It would move and shit like that.
And those
like,
are pretty intense, shots, dude. Yeah. Compared to, like, what NARM is doing. When they do cash shots, they fucking clear out, like, 250 yards from the shot in all areas. Sometimes... No, when they do cash shots, they'll close the entire pit down and move everything as much as they can out. And that thing will fucking rock shit.
Oh, I bet.
But the craziest thing ever is one of those halter tires. They were backing up to the hopper. And we got two shops right here and a hopper right here. And the hopper's probably fucking a football field and a half away from our shop. But the inside dual fucking boom, blew.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
ripped a shitload of shit on that haul truck apart like the hydraulic tank came off. But Jesus. Our shop was sitting there like the whole shop shook. All the doors and dust was falling everywhere. Everybody's like, what the fuck just happened,
damn.
Dude? Walk outside and the tires is fucking blown up.
That's... God damn.
We had one blow up and fucking obliterate a fucking camp. Now we have like bomb-proof camps instead of like old-ass trailer camps.
Uh-huh.
Because they were all parked around camp for lunch and one blew up and like injured 8 people. And one guy had like collapsed damn. Lung from the pressure that ripped it away. And it's like probably from me to where my truck is, and that fucking thing blows shit up.
Wow.
It's fucking awesome.
That's nuts, dude.
That would suck. Just be sitting there eating, and bam, not even hear anything, and there's just like the fucking shit is ripped apart, and you and your buddies are just laying around like your name just went off inside your bunker. What the fuck just happened? Shit's fucking crazy.
Mm-hmm.
What did they blow shit up with? Dynamite?
Not really. Yeah, it is dynamite, but it's like... one part diesel fuel, and then there's like these little beads that are like, I can't remember what they are. They're part diesel too, but they do a mixture of the shit, and they'll load. We'll dig like 150 feet in the ground, and then they'll load it like up to like 50 to 80 feet. And if they do a cash on, it's like 90 feet of just straight dynamite. And there's like over 140 holes on a cash shot. Oh, man, I got one on my phone, dude. It's pretty legit. And, like, I caught one from sitting on top, and you can just see all the shots coming straight up.
Cool.
It's fucking awesome. You only get to see good ones, though, if you're, like, a blaster.
That'd be a fun job.
Yeah, no shit.
My grandfather was a blaster. He'd get to hit the cap, and then you'd see the core just light up and go right in there, and bam, 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 shit just goes off. I got a couple shots that are pretty cool.
Should I remember that one year we went to Custer, and, we saw that, what is that fucking statue?
It's crazy horse?
Yeah, yeah.
It's not even finished. Crazy horse, yeah. The Indian that's
If we saw that fucker get blasted one night, they had like this big old like ceremony fucking thing, but that was pretty sweet.
I've seen that too, man.
Yeah.
It was a really long time ago. I was super young.
Mm-hmm.
You know the biggest monument that we have that's unfinished, but everybody still attracts most to it? Mount Rushmore.
Yeah.
Unfinished and still laying with all the garbage around it.
Yeah.
It's like a fully just fucking undone shit. Have you ever seen the real plans to that?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
That was intense, man.
Yeah.
Like, they're all standing up and stuff. Like, what the fuck? Those heads were huge as shit.
Yeah.
Well, that crazy works. They said that won't... They were supposed to be done 2020, but they just moved it back another 20 years.
Probably. I don't know.
It'll be cool if it ever gets done.
Fuck yeah. Yeah. But I heard it's just like a volunteer shit. Like people just volunteer to go up there and help out.
Really?
Yeah. Because.
Yeah, I don't think they pay anybody.
Yeah, they don't.
You just see donations everywhere and shit.
Hmm.
Yeah, it's kind of gay. You can't actually like go walk out on it.
Arm and shit.
But.
Eventually,
yeah, any of that. Yeah. It's just. I guarantee you the reason why they probably fucking. Why won't you do it? Is because they're afraid people are just gonna keep falling off it or
not fucking falling. They're gonna fucking jump, dude.
Yeah,
jump.
They'd use that as like a fucking suicide spot. There's a lot of places all over. Like every time, like I know now why they put fucking the cages up on like the crosswalks over the trains. Because yeah. People would jump off that shit.
Oh no, shit.
Yep. I know that's why we got it in Gillette. There was a girl that was up there and a train was coming. She jumped. And now there's like a big ass gate with like hooks over the top so you can't climb over it. I used to ride my bike over that shit.
Do you remember that time we were fucking riding bikes over to your brother's house? This fucking guy, dude.
That's a nice dog, man.
Yeah, like, so, I don't know. You lived a ways away. Well, I guess I was living with you.
A block and a half.
No.
He lived in David's neighborhood, but he lived a block.
Oh, yeah, yeah, David. Yeah.
That's what.
But I was talking about, like, you lived a ways away from.
Yeah, I live fucking probably a good 5 miles.
Yeah. Well, we rode our fucking bikes over to his brother's house, and I was like, dude, check it out, man. That's a nice-looking dog. And it was a nice-looking fucking dog, dude. I think it was on a Sunday, because I think we were sitting there watching football and shit.
Yeah.
Well, shit, at the time, Corbin was probably, what, maybe like 2 years old or something?
Fuck, if that. He was just, maybe two. He was a little dude, though.
And fucking, all of a sudden, we're just sitting there, you know, fucking drinking beers. All of a sudden, there's a knock on the door. And, like, Dave opens up the door, and they're like,
talking shit about my yard?
You guys are talking shit about my yard?
What?
Dave's like, what are you talking about? I don't think anybody was talking shit about your yard. Oh, it's Dave, like those people over yard? There.
That yard?
Yeah.
Look at that yard.
That
was all maggot, all angry. Yeah. And then me and you and him just all stood at the door like, what the fuck, bro?
Well, it was like, what did he say? If you guys want to go right now, we could go. And then fucking me and Travis stood up. We're like, the fuck are you even talking about, dude? Like, you know what I mean? Sweet. Fucking douchebag. I don't know. But yeah, Dave just shuts the door and fucking
just right in his face. Like, I'm done with your shit.
Yeah.
We all sat down and went back to watching football. Some crazy
There's some weird motherfuckers.
Weird dudes. And Dave's like, that guy probably just needs to go back and hit that crack like one more time.
Yeah, I didn't even say anything about his yard or anything. I said, that's a nice looking dog. Or whatever.
Yeah, I think his old lady was out there with the dog and shit. Like, that's a nice dog, man.
Probably, she heard you wrong.
She's like, these motherfuckers talk shit about my yard?
Yeah,
hell no.
They were riding their bikes and said, fuck your yard.
Hey, yo, bitch, fuck that yard. It's dirty. We're just the gang of yard yellers, all right? We don't have a yard. We're swinging by.
You're the Siskel and Ebert of yard rim.
Yeah. Fucking Bob Vila of landscaping.
Fucking young ass guys on bikes. Go fuck that yard.
The Al Borland of lawnmower.
Yeah.
That actually be Hank Hill.
Yeah.
That's fucking awesome.
Fucking just wear coveralls all the time.
No shirt, just coveralls. And a big old fucking straw cap.
Fucking Blake always wears fucking coveralls. When he's fucking playing. Well, maybe not always, but he did again last night. Fuck, I can't remember
Is he in three bands? Yeah. I'm like, fuck, man. I saw him up there when I first played, and he's like, that's the fucking guitarist for Beastwood. I'm like, alright, cool. So he's got two bands. Beastwood gets off, and he's back up there. I'm like, Jesus. If you put more effort into just one band, I think he'd be alright. All that energy he has, dude, he's just up there hella fucking rocking it, though. He's a good fucking guitar player.
Man. Yeah, he's a good dude, man.
Yeah, Blake's good shit.
I've never met the guy, but he seems like fucking wild cat, dude.
Well, I figured last night we'd fucking all just get together or something and fucking, I don't know. So you should always just grab beers and then fucking go somewhere.
Yeah, I figured that's what he was going to do. By fucking Stevie V, bro.
Yeah, dude, big time.
Oh, you saw that shit?
Yeah, man.
Fuck, dude.
I was right there when it happened. I was like, whoa. Because he walked up and she just went grinding the... right into the crowd.
Let's go, man. Let's go. She's like, oh, fuck. She gave me her name, but I can't fucking remember it for the life of me. I looked
she
up
looks
for
probably
like an hour and a half, man. I looked up like an hour and a half. She said, like... I have no idea what she said, but it was like Melissa or like Something with an M. It was something weird. I just sounded out twice because I was so trashed.
Miranda?
No, it was like a...
Laquita.
Maria? Melissa? It was like something weird. Mariah. I think it was like Mariah.
I think it was Leslie.
I think it was... Their name was Timothy. Yeah. Right? And you saved me, bro. Yeah. You're like, that's not a girl, man.
Yeah. Yep.
Cut it out. Now that's bigger than both of ours. Let's go.
Look at that. I used to work with this one dude, and he moved to fucking Denver. Well, anyway, there was a fucking Mercury's concert or whatever. But, like, dude, when we got there, like, he's like, I just want to let you know you gotta watch him. And I'm like, yeah? What are you talking about? Careful, he's like, man. Dude, they'll snag up your old ladies. Just like that. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about, man?
Fucking clued me in.
I'm like, number one, I'm pretty pissed because you fucking literally just told me that you still had tickets available. And then when my old lady was going to come down there. And I went up there to get her one. They're like, nope, we don't have any tickets. I'm like, get the fuck out of here. You just told me. I was pretty pissed, dude. But yeah, it was kind of funny. He was like, so where we were at, there's like kind of like a slanted fucking thing. And it had like a railing. So we're just like chilling right there. And this guy down below, no bullshit, this is true story. Like I'm standing right there. And then like there's like the dance floor or whatever right down here. Well, this guy is literally, okay, he puts his hand up on that rail. And him and his old lady are fucking dance, whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And little fucking dude like looks down at it and he's like, he like moves in closer to this old lady and shit. It's like he fucking grabbed that guy's arm and he's like, nope, not today. And then like
what the fuck? What's not?
Not really sure what I should do right now.
Today.
Yeah, and well, the guy down below too, you know, he's just kind of like, man, what the fuck, you know. And then so we're standing there, we actually went outside and smoked and then we came back in, and then I came in before he did, and I'm standing there, and then they came back, and then all of a sudden this fucking dude, no bullshit, walked up to him and was like, dude, better watch your lady, man. Because I just might have to fuck you up. I'm like, what in the fuck is going on right now? I just want to watch the show.
Now I'm involved in this. Yep, I don't know what the fuck's going on, shit.
And I was like, well, after the show was over and everything, Mercules was like, well, I'll be outside for a free meet and greet or whatever. And I'm like, fuck. It was like pretty late, dude. You know, and we're like, yeah, I think we're going to take off. And I'm like, fuck, well, I guess, well, his old lady's like, well, we'll walk with you if you just want to go to the hotel. And I'm like, all right, sweet. I guess I'll just fucking go now. Because there's no way in hell I would have fucking made it all the way back to that hotel. It was a ways away.
Really?
Yeah, and I was walking down the street, and it was one of those deals like, when you're so fucked up and you're just like, God, I shouldn't even be outside right now.
Yeah.
Like, I was fucking falling down and shit. And yeah, it wasn't good, dude.
Sounds like a fucking great time.
Yeah.
I went to go reach out for that stop sign and it ended up on my face. And, do we got a listener or anything?
Negative.
Negative.
I almost got ran over in Deadwood.
No,
almost died. Fucking during St. Paddy's Day pub crawl, there's like this parade. Mm-hmm. They're like throwing beads or some shit, and I was super wasted. And I just fucking went to grab him and just fucking ate shit. And like, there's like a car right there, stopped like right here. And like, this person standing next to us, or no, Lisa fucking grabbed me and pulled me up real quick, and drug me back onto the sidewalk. Like, I almost fucking got my head ran over.
Damn, that would have fucking sucked, fucking dude. Retarded.
Deadwood, man, it'll get you every time we go drinking. I got my first fucking DUI ever right there.
No shit.
Yeah. Your jailhouse is fucking weird.
Yeah. I got another little...
It just, like, lays together.
I got another little fucking...
Just a blanket.
Fucking topic shit. So, what is your opinion? Or your thoughts on Deadwood versus Vegas?
Never been to Vegas, so my opinion really doesn't
matter. Oh, really?
But... It's a lot less people, but I think you have a higher chance at winning. If you like the gamble, I think you would have a higher chance at winning in Deadwood, just not as much money.
Yeah.
Because people hit jackpots there all the time.
Yeah.
Dude, you know what? It was crazy that time that we were down there for your fucking shit or whatever. When you guys went back up to the room, and then we went to ours or whatever, this fucking old lady won all this fucking money on the slot machine thing. And they were literally, like, just handing it to her. Like, what the...
Yep.
Like, you guys are going to give this lady fucking security walking back up there, right? Yeah, I mean...
I think sometimes they do. They'll even escort you to your car.
Really?
Because people, I remember this father and his son... actually got caught fucking counting cards, but they won all this fucking money and they were up there fucking getting their money. And I saw two fucking pit bosses come over and start talking to them, but they started handing them that money and then they escorted them to their vehicle and then they left.
Jesus.
Holy shit.
That was pretty crazy. And when I won $1,600 on that cruise ship, my dumb ass should have said, can we get the taxes taken out of this right now?
Nope, didn't do that.
That was fucking great.
Oh,
but they handed it to me right there, and I fucking zipped out of that bitch. I wasn't sitting around. This old lady was sitting next to me. She's like, I'll watch your machine. I'm like, I bet you will, bitch. Because I had to, like, go hunt down somebody to fucking come cash me the fuck out.
Yeah.
Dude, a guy I worked with won $7,900 at the Beacon.
Jesus.
And then about 2 weeks later, he won $5,000. No bullshit. I seen both the receipts you showed me. And it was like he went down to lunch one day and won $5,000.
Jesus.
Came back to work like, hey, I just won $5,000.
Yeah. You remember the old Attitudes building in Gillette? That's now like a fucking slot machine casino.
Oh, yeah.
Like one of the horse racing bullshit.
No, that's in fucking Sundance. And that's some bullshit. But they probably do.
That's here. That's
oh, really?
How, yeah. That's how they're able to get away with
it. Oh, yeah.
You know,
see, that's what...
It's horse betting.
Yeah.
I don't know how it is, but you can win good money.
Bejeweled, and this is horse racing, whatever. No, but there's people that go in there, old people, and they'll fucking walk out with like $600, $800 all the fucking time. And I'm like,
dude, Galloway's fucking pays out good. I know somebody that won $3,300 there, and there's a jackpot. There was a jackpot there for like $32,000.
Jesus, they're gonna. I saw something the other day where they're changing the
on the border.
Is it on the border? I thought I saw something with like Apple, like an Applebee's.
Oh, that too. They're doing it to that too. On the border and Applebee's are going to fucking just weird casino things.
Yeah. Because that's going to attract all the great folks.
Yeah.
Let me tell you.
Look at Gillette. We're full of
Indians. Dude, have you been into that fucking Wyoming Downs place? Fucking.
At the Shiloh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Holy fuck.
It's a dingy fuck.
Yeah, that's no joke. There's fucking like a bunch of people in there and they're just sitting there fucking.
Oh, yeah.
Grinding their teeth and fucking.
Yeah.
Just praying to God their last 20 gets them somewhere.
Yeah. I need a bump.
Yeah, I had to go up on the roof.
Oh. Gillette's has fucking real actual horse racing, though.
Really?
They do it like once a week or something.
I thought they've had that for a while, though.
They never really had it, but they always had the shit. Like, back in the day, they used to have it all the time.
Yeah, I was going to say, weren't there like Gillette Downs or something?
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
G-Town Downs. I've never been to
it, but it was pretty cool. I'm like, wow, they actually got horse racing up here now? Because when I was in Ireland, dude, that's all they do is bet on horses at the pub just all day. Guys will have lists in front of them just betting that shit. Like, I don't get what the fucking.
Yeah, they shit do is like weird parlays. And
yeah,
all
like
crazy.
You could do like
shit.
20 on this 20, but also give him a 20 if he bets on this one. I'm like, that's too much shit. Just no way.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
time for that.
I don't follow all that either. Like, people are like, yeah, this is how you do it, and it makes it all complicated. Like, I want to pick that team.
Yeah, you see the color blue right there? Yep, that's the one I want. Pick that one.
Yeah.
Well, we are slowly getting to the 45-minute marker here. Thanks for listening.
See, that's a great time to stop it, huh?
Yep. Yeah.
One of the guests has to use the urinal outhouse facilities.
Man. It's the outhouse.
Yeah, the outhouse.
Technically, it's just a shed, you know.
But
we call it the outhouse.
Yeah. So, thanks for listening. Shit, we could. What do you think? Should we do another one?
Let's talk about another one.
We could do another one. Yep, it's only 10:30. Yeah, so, we're gonna. We're gonna do another one. So,
stay tuned.
Yeah. So this is number one.
This is part one, dude.
And here goes out to. Here's the Beastwood Jam, River of Life.
Another river of life. My body becomes so cold.